Jacktober. Not much Jacktober left. What's the date today?
Well,
my goodness.
October 28th.
I'm going to miss Jacktober.
We might have to make it a regular feature. Not like... Not every day. Nah, like once, maybe once every 2 weeks. We just got to change the name of it or something.
Just for filler.
Well, no, it's just for some
on those slow days.
Oh, original
we'll
material.
Count on you to find more of these hacky radio shows. We can't like go a whole year without doing this.
A whole year without listening to this dreck.
What if we go one every one a month, one every 2 weeks? I think we could pull that off.
We'll call it Jocktober all year round.
No, we have 20 guys that work for us behind the scenes. Come up with a fucking name that works, will you?
You got it.
Thank you.
Happy Jocktober, everybody, from your friends at the Opie and Anthony Show. I wanna rock! It's a celebration of hacky, pukey radio shows and DJs from across this great nation of ours.
The black and the berry, the sweet and the juice, baby!
There was a lot of energy there for some reason, but it's like wasted energy.
Yeah.
It's like sitting in your driveway in neutral and just gassing it.
Strike up the crapola, it's Jocktober.
There's a person stranded.
There's a show.
It's stranded.
My rebuttal is, the old mama.
I like that.
What the hell was that?
Happy Jocktober, everybody, from your friends at the Opie and Anthony Show.
Ha ha. Let's all do it.
Ha 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 ha.
There was no joy attached to that sound.
None.
I want to go backwards for 1 second, then we'll go right into Jocktober, because this is a good line. Jason from Gettysburg, he writes, if the best live show is about getting the entire crowd to do the same thing, then the best show was Great White. They got everyone to run for their lives at the same time.
Oof.
Too soon?
That fucking footage, dude, I've seen footage of that.
It's horrifying.
But did you see the footage of them
by the door?
They get crammed in the
door?
They
get piled up at the doorway?
It's horrible. I was actually thinking that last night.
Like, I can't get out. My ass is burning.
They were trying to pull people out from the outside. They were just jammed in the door.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ant can relate to this because it was... I had to intro a lot of horrendous bands in these rock clubs on Long Island, and Anthony played in these joints. What are we doing?
Oh, no, I was just reading one of the headlines.
The
white out outrage.
Oh, okay.
Complaints about university shirt.
Why?
I don't know what it is.
I don't know. We're going to find out.
I don't know what a white out is.
But, Ant, you can relate to this with those rock clubs on Long Island. This should have happened way sooner than it did.
Oh, yeah.
Where the bands would come in with their homemade pyrotechnics.
Dude, I was the guy.
Oh, you actually did it yourself.
I fucking blew up more shit in more shitty fire trap clubs on Long Island.
What was the one on Deer Park Avenue? Because it actually, there was a fire on stage one night when I was there.
Coincidentally enough, it was called Sparks.
Sparks, which ended up going up in flames when I think no one was in there.
Cheers was another one on Deer Park Avenue that was just a tinder box waiting to burn. And I used to go to the there was a place that sold stage equipment and whatnot, and they sold a flash powder, photographic flash powder. And I'd buy like bottles of this stuff and dump it into soup cans that were wrapped in duct tape.
Yeah.
And I'd have rocket igniters threaded through the bottom. And on little clips, and just pour this on there, and hit a button on the floor. Boom! These fucking things went off, just 10 feet of fire and sparks into the ceiling, the rafters. One time at Augie's Checkered Flag Lounge in Kingston, the curtain caught on fire behind us, and we had to like start stomping it out.
And they just would allow you to do this. The guys that own these rock clubs,
they
didn't question what Anthony Cumia was doing from Rock Gut.
Whatever.
They just assumed you knew what you were doing, and you, frankly, didn't know what you were doing. You didn't do a lot of testing.
I had a handheld one I made out of PVC that I spray-painted camouflage. Looked exactly like a bazooka. And I went to Radio Shack, got the battery, the buttons, and everything like that, and put a pistol grip on it, and loaded it up the same way. I'd take flash paper. You know, the magicians use that flash paper shit. And wrap up flash powder in it, and then put a rocket igniter in. I'd have the wires hooked up inside this bazooka thing, way deep in, so it actually made a boom! Loud sound, fire shoots out the front, and I'd shoot the drummer's drum kit with it. And then the drum kit would have another thing, and the drummer would hit a button. The second I shoot the bazooka, he would hit a button, and his drum set would blow up. Oh, I couldn't blow enough shit up.
Did you have video of this?
Oh, yeah. Joe's got it.
What the fuck?
Joe's
Let's get
got
that
a
up
bunch
on
of
YouTube.
That shit. I could not blow enough shit up on stage.
Yeah.
It's great.
So when we heard about the Great White thing, which really sucked for those people and their families and all that, we all understand that.
Oh, yeah.
But my first thought was, this should have happened years ago.
Years ago.
Because people were getting away with murder in these rock clubs.
Someone commenting on my blowing stuff up, and then it just says, Co-fucking-Kane. Yes, it was.
Co-fucking-Kane!
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That was the shot.
Yeah, I was on that stage when I saw some flames hit the fucking... Well, I wasn't on the stage, but after I was off the stage. Is that you?
No.
Okay.
Bunch of rot guts now. Fuck them.
Fuck them all, right? Let's do Jocktober. Today, we're into a new theme.
Yeah.
The beginning of Jocktober was a bunch of couple acts where you weren't sure if they were married or not.
This is a little crossover, though.
Because, oh, okay. It has a little of that.
Uh-huh.
Well, we're also looking at some of our old radio stations that we got kicked off.
Right. Yesterday, we were hanging out with Chunky on 92.3
right.
Now. Remember?
Oh, who could forget?
Yeah, I think he's trying to tweet me or something.
Like, no, really?
And I'm like, go away.
Ew.
I really do hate you.
What did he say?
Because you have no business doing radio in New York City, so don't even bother.
He's got Yankee hat on.
Yeah, good for him. He's from fucking Detroit.
Huh?
He doesn't like the fucking Yankees. I think I got a tweet from him, unless someone was fucking with me.
Who fucking came?
Says, whatever. He's trying to be nice. I'm like, no, we fucked and trashed you because we think you suck.
Why would he try to be nice after you trashed him?
I don't know.
For no reason.
I don't know.
Like, he made fun of him for no reason and mocked his profession.
Right.
And then he decides that he's going to reach out and be your friend.
And he's still trying to be my friend.
I'm
like, go away. You're on our old station. We have to hate you.
Yeah.
You know, if that new station was doing something, then we'd have to admit, oh, wow, all right, I guess they knew what they were doing in the end.
Yeah.
But they just suck all around.
Well.
All right, let's go. So now we go down to West Palm Beach, Florida. This was a biggie. This radio station from the beginning hated us. I remember when we sat down with CBS Radio and they were showing us all our affiliates that they gave us. It was a sweet list. And
list.
Do you remember in the conference room we were talking to all the PDs? What they were doing in the individual markets to try to, you know, get the show up and rolling.
Of course.
And this guy was fucking pissed that he had to take our show. From day one, he made it very clear to the company.
Yep, we could tell.
He wanted a local fucking show. And the company at the time, because we had Joel Hollander that had our back.
Yep.
He's like, nope, you're going to take this show and you're going to make the best of it and you're going to make it work. And we did make it work. We really did.
Yep.
Were we just kicking complete ass in West Palm Beach, Florida? No, we'll be the first to admit that. But we were number one in our demo and we were doing very well.
We were.
And they didn't, we went down there. It was so uncomfortable to be down there. There was not any fucking signs for the morning show at an event that 20,000 people were at. It's like, you sabotaging motherfuckers.
And then it was time for us to go on stage, and they're like, all right, go out there. Like, there was no, like, when you do something like that, you get a Kenny or somebody to really pump up the fact that your morning show is now making their first appearance in your city. But they're like, all right, just go out there.
It was fucking horrible, dude. It was fucking horrible. And when I was down there doing gigs recently, they wanted no part of me on the station. So fuck that whole station. They're cornball fucking alternative rock. They stink.
So we lost Joel Hollander, and the guy who took his place, you know, let's be honest with each other here, he didn't really have our back. So then he
didn't really have our back. Yes, he did, with a fucking knife.
Yeah.
Dan Mason? No, he didn't have our backs
at all.
I'm
trying to be polite.
No.
He finally decided that, let these radio stations do what they want, and if they want to do a local thing, then let them do a local thing. So we got shown the door, and they replaced us with the famous Loper and Smitty show, where they do the Lopewisers for all the people that our faithful listeners of this radio show, you know what we're talking about. And now they've added a chick named Randy.
Yes, Loper and Smitty, since we last visited them, quickly became Loper, Smitty, and Randy. And the thing that makes it fun is Randy and Loper are engaged to be married.
Wow, that's wild.
Yeah, so you get to kind of go on that road with them. You know how exciting it is when your relatives get married and you get to hear about it all the time?
Yeah, it's thrill a minute.
It really is.
I got
happy for them.
Yeah, you just want to hear about it so much.
I got engaged and married, and we might have spent an hour talking about it in the last year. Total, yes. Yeah.
Wonderful.
Enough.
So here we go. This is the show that replaced us, which, by the way, E-Rock showed me the ratings yesterday. They're doing absolutely fucking nothing.
In the shitter.
Hard to believe.
So
are we doing poor?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. In the end, we're always right.
Good.
I mean, come on. Loper, Smitty, and Randy, Morning Buzz Sweeper. Here we go.
Live, local, and very vocal.
You need to do something about your B.O.
The Morning Buzz.
With Loper, Smitty, and Randy.
Deep voice guy.
That fucking radio. And it's just terrestrial radio in general.
I fucking love it.
Will you stop with the fucking making it sound like it's the coolest thing?
It's cool.
It's local, so fucking phony, man.
Another one with local, but this time and local vocal. And vocal.
Oh, that rhymes with what else rhymes with local?
This is not a top 40 station. This is not something for girls or teenagers or whatever. This is Florida's new rock alternative.
All right.
This is a rock and roll type of deal here. They're vocal and local.
Well, local, of course.
Vocal and local, like the dramatic guy voice.
Is the morning show numbers?
Yeah, you want me to do it?
What is this, for the whole station?
That's just, these two are for the morning show, that's for the station.
What?
Yeah.
Okay. Why is the PD still in fucking place there? And I know that stupid FMQB, and I like Mike, but they gave him some kind of award for, like, being a good PD or something. I noticed that one, Mike. We're going to have to talk about that.
Mike?
The station that took us off the air about a year or so ago, overall, they're in 16th place. Wow. That means the whole station. 16th
cranking.
Place. Can I bet you we could get someone that lived in West Palm Beach their entire lives. And they can't name 16 radio stations in their fucking city. I guarantee that. This station's in 16th place. And the morning show, Men 18 to 49, that was our demo. They went from a 0.5 share to a 0.9 share. How bad is that?
That's a nice jump up.
Let's just put it this way. In our heyday when we were killing in Philly and Cleveland, we had 20 shares.
Yeah.
Not 0.20 shares.
Something.
20 shares.
Yeah.
This fucking show that replaced us went from a 0.5 to a 0.9. So they're going up a little bit.
Yeah.
18 plus, which they should just destroy. 0.2 to 0.3. They're fucking doing nothing.
That's terrible.
And
that's
no one's listening.
And, you know, I yelled and screamed as much as I could. And, you know, stupid D'Olivero thinks I'm nuts and stuff. But am I nuts, Chris? Am I really?
That was about
really? You allowed this to happen.
But that corny
fucking nothing.
That corny format, the fucking corny radio teasers. It's nobody wants to hear that shit in the era of iPods.
Local.
Nobody cares if it's local.
I can't get local on my iPod.
I want local and vocal for Pete's sake.
Yes.
Where can I go for that?
Actually, this has both.
Really?
Oh.
Yeah.
Not easy to find.
You know what? I get local, and when I pop on AM radio for the traffic and the weather on the way in. And that's my local. That's all I need. And that's if I didn't pick up my fucking iPhone and just go, well, I could hit the weather thing. It knows where I am.
Yeah.
So it gives me the local weather. All the local information I need is on my fucking iPhone. I don't need some clown-ass fucking hacks to be local for me.
Just check my widget before I leave the house.
Well,
yes.
You know,
check your widget.
One button.
We know our listeners are savvy. If they're in some, I don't know, let's throw a city out there, Columbus. You know, the ONA listener in Columbus, like Ann said, they're getting their local shit really quick. You could get it really fast.
You don't need it on the radio anymore.
You can see what your sports teams are doing, what the big local story is, and that's it.
We're not talking about, when we talk about the World Series, and I mentioned the Yankees and stuff, I'm not doing that to try to be local to the New York people. I'm doing it because I'm interested in it.
And
if somebody in fucking California isn't, I could give a shit. I'm just doing it because that's what I'm interested in. To get the local angle on something is irrelevant in this day and age. Everyone could get what they need locally on any electronic device, on numerous television station, whatever the fuck. We're not as local as these people think we need to be.
You know, all the talented people on regular radio were pushed out a long time ago at this point. I'm talking about, you know, there's a few exceptions, because then now people call up with their favorite show that's still making it happen, but I mean, there you are.
Fuck them in the ass.
There's not many left, okay? Most of the shows are long gone. Most of the PDs that know what they're doing in radio, long gone. A lot of them doing the satellite radio thing or new ventures. You know, they're moving into the fucking, you know, internet world and whatnot.
Drug dealing, whatever.
The management, please. Management, those guys are long gone.
You don't think that station's doing anything new or original?
Oh. You haven't given him a chance.
That's a good point.
Sam's a douche.
You're being judgmental.
Prejudging.
Yes.
None of these guys could think for themselves. So one person comes up with an idea. One person came up with, I know what we need to do to compete with satellite radio. We got to go local. So then everyone, local, 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 local. And it just went down the chain, and everyone just started, screaming local at the top.
Local. That's the big thing that'll work. What happened to the Jack format? Where'd that go?
I think it's still on. I've heard it in L.A. Like, it still does well in one place. I don't even remember where I was.
No, and that was the battle but that cry was supposed to be every fucking station.
That was supposed to be everywhere. The new one is they're going to try to do, like, FM sports talk.
Oh, why don't they fucking
That's the new
stop?
One. That's the new one. You're going to see a lot of
Have
sports
fun.
Sports talk going to FM stations.
Oh, you assholes. Guy talk. Guy talk.
Guy talk.
How about stop cutting the balls off the personalities that you haven't fucking hung out to dry and let them
people.
Be entertaining, you special interest pussies, and then people will be compelled to listen to
them. They'll offend people. Back in the heyday of talk radio, it was all about saying whatever the fuck you wanted, living on the edge, whatever the fuck. Now, you can't even get close. You can't see the edge. They don't allow you to get close to the edge. They're all pussies. The FCC fucked everything up by increasing fines tenfold
to
$350,000 per occurrence, per station. So it got the radio stations going, we can't afford to have a guy slip up and say something that's going to get us fined. It used to be the cost of doing business. If you got a fucking $35,000 fine, that was nothing to a radio station that was making money hand over fist through advertising because the shows were cutting edge, funny.
And what they used to call regular radio?
What?
A license to print money.
Yeah.
That's
how well they did.
Wow.
Now there's
they really
so
said that
much,
over and over again.
There's so much shit now fucking it up. So many hands in the old soup. Super Rooney. That no one could do anything. So it's reduced to this. This dreck that we're going to hear, I'm prejudging. That's why no one's listening. That's why they're at a point fucking...
Amazing. You can't... That's really tough to do, to be that bad.
And when you're competing with so much different media out there, you got to start doing something special, original, new, different. And what do? They go back into their primitive fucking radio shitholes and pull out the same bag of tricks they've been using that just doesn't work.
Right.
Sucks!
I'm amazed the FCC and the government allowed that to happen, too, by making the fines a lot higher because it just destroyed the business.
They don't see it that way. They think it's going to be a public service. Now it's going to be great, good radio, wholesome, local.
Now they're going to have to deal with all these companies going bankrupt.
Yep.
Really?
Have
in the
fun.
End, in the end, what do they accomplish?
Have fun.
The gang, panel, let's get into this Loper, Smitty, and Randy thing from West Palm Beach. They're on the buzz, everyone.
Yes. And as we begin...
Now watch, we just start cracking up. It's the funniest shit we ever
I know, watch it be hilarious.
We're all jealous.
Hey, Lopweiser, get me one, too.
Okay, probably not.
We also need to take note that how often and how specific they are about where their callers are from, how often they repeat... By the way, he's from...
Because it's got to be local.
Yes, they're hitting all points of
the area.
Dude,
when you listen to
the
radio, you don't give a
no
shit
one cares.
If a fucking
no
local town
no
is
one gives
mentioned.
A shit.
No one cares.
So you know how that PD is probably telling them, look, here's... And they didn't come up with that idea. They weren't like, hey, let me make sure we throw in the caller's
You just want
location.
An interesting phone call.
Yeah, the PD,
or a
though,
funny phone call
the
or something.
The PD gets in there and goes,
who gives
hey,
a shit?
Make sure you mention where the call is from. That local angle is so important, guys. You keep plugging it. And they've probably got a sign in the studio. Guaranteed. Keep it local.
And vocal.
And vocal. Like, they probably got those so they
What's
see
the vocal
it all the
part?
Time.
That's
yeah,
when...
Florida! it's got to be, like, local, vocal, and loud.
All right. Let's find out. The gang starts a new game called Guess What Dead Guy Randy's Doing.
Whoa.
Who's Randy?
Randy is the young lady.
The young lady?
Oh, yeah.
We saw a picture of her, right? She's kind of a blonde.
Great legs.
We can't really bash her for being a pig because she's very attractive.
She's lovely looking.
Here we go.
Now, you heard AFI. We do have AFI tickets, and we also have a brand new game. Name of the game is Guess What Dead Guy Randy's Doing. Just in time for Halloween, kids.
That's right, guys.
Guess what dead guy Randy's doing.
Can you explain this game?
I said the applause.
Yeah.
Like the phony, the applause button they push.
They just laugh at the guess what dead guy Randy's doing. Yeah.
That's a funny name we didn't even hear 3 seconds ago in the break.
It's awful. They like that applause sound effect. I hope you enjoy hearing that.
Oh, really? A lot of it.
I do. Makes it sound like a festive atmosphere. Like there's a lot of people and they're clapping and laughing when there's none.
Oh.
Remind me, Kevin from Connecticut, I think, on my Twitter last night, he sent me two fucking clips of Dan Ingram saying cunt. Beautiful for Jocktober.
Really?
Oh. Yeah, you guys will have to get that for me so we can play for everybody. Pretty good stuff. Thank you, Kevin. I should have fucking wrote you back last night. All right, back to this thing.
Guess what dead guy Randy's doing?
Can you explain this game? Because this sounds like a pretty borderline illegal game.
Oh.
Guess what? Is it a game full of bunch of dead guys, and you're the queen of necrophiliacs? Is that how this game works out?
I'm an impersonator.
Oh, you're an impersonator. So you're going to impersonate dead people. You're going to give me, like, a voice impersonation. You'll probably throw some character traits in there.
Oh, I know what she's going to do first. The station's ratings.
Oh, gosh. Guess what dead guy she's doing down there on Okeechobee Boulevard. You know, down there in West Palm. Oof. Oh, gee. That's right. It's going out to everybody at the Big City Tavern on Clematis Street in West Palm Beach. Just want to say hi to everybody down there.
If you're not looking at a map, I'm throwing hot coffee in your face. If you know those fucking shitty street names.
What do you think? I put in West Palm Hotspots.
Okay, good.
And Google.
And she's stepping over that drunk Billy Mac laying there. That's where Billy Mac lives. Billy Mac!
Character traits in there.
Yeah.
And we're going to have to guess exactly what dead person you are impersonating, right?
Yeah, it's going
to
be tough.
Okay.
There's been a lot of dead people this year.
Yeah, I know.
Lots of dead people.
I got a list.
You got a spectrum? Got a list.
I got a list.
Holy shit. That's.
Why are they laughing at that, though?
I don't know. They just have to, like, laugh. I think they just...
She has a list.
They just randomly laugh and stuff.
Oh, God.
But it brings up another point we've made too many times for some of the faithful listeners. When you hear that hot fucking radio voice, she's the biggest fucking pig. This girl is actually hot, and she's...
She's getting ready. That's not her regular voice.
It kind of sounds like a regular voice.
She's starting with her...
She's starting to get into character.
Impression
like
voice.
Like Mr. Imus.
That's right.
I was out late down at John Bull English Pub on Village Boulevard last night, keeping it local. Keeping it local.
And vocal.
And vocal.
I want a Lopweiser.
Do you want a Lopweiser?
I do.
Do we get to hear some Lopweisers?
I'm not going to sit here and give spoilers.
Right. Thank you.
That's a Lopweiser. Yeah. It's actually cum mixed with fizz and a swizzle stick.
That's wonderful. Yes.
Let's meet the contestants for the new game and get many douche chills. Here we go.
Ghost. That is ghostly sounds, my friend. It's Loper, Smitty, Randy, a.k.a. LSR, live and local.
LSR.
The game is called Guess...
Wait, what did he say?
He said LSR, live and local.
LSR. Oh, okay. It's LSR. See, Loper.
Do they got t-shirts made? LSR.
Smitty and Randy. It's LSR, dude.
And where are they? Live and...
Local.
There's nothing worse than forced... branding.
LSR, everybody.
That's fucking horrendous.
Yeah.
What are you talking about, brother man?
I don't know.
Mother hucka, I'm going to fuck you up.
They should fucking just jump off the Flagler Memorial Bridge is what I believe they should do.
Hope they don't crash through the front window of the West Palm Beach Improv.
Actually,
it's the only thing in that fucking city that I like. That club pays me well.
Message to Anthony.
We get it.
Hey, I'm keeping it local and vocal.
Actually, please do. Keep doing that. And if you have to explain that they're scary sounds, maybe they're not scary sounds.
That's a ghost sound.
Hey, that's pretty scary.
LSR, live and local.
Andy, a.k.a. LSR, live and local. The game is called Guess What Dead Guy Randy's Doing. Now, normally this might upset me, but today this makes me smile. Randy's impersonations are nothing less than radio gold, so make sure you stick around. Let's see here. We have Dylan, who is cruising down 95. What's up, brah?
Nothing, man. On my way up.
What's up, brah?
What's up, brah? He didn't just say, what's up, brah?
He certainly did, James.
That makes my neck itch.
What's up, brah?
I want to pull in one of my skin tags right now.
Ow.
Stephen S. Rabatia, LSR equals. Why didn't we come up with this?
Uh-huh.
Lousy shit radio. Yeah.
Now that's LSR.
Yeah, lousy
that's
shit
right,
radio.
Brah.
What's up, brah?
We hear that again. I want to hear that because that's a really cool way to talk.
No.
I want to learn to do that.
No, we can't play that again.
Come on, Bray. Nope. I can't do it. How do you do it?
Let's see here. We have Dylan, who is cruising down 95. What's up, brah?
What's
up, brah? What's up, brah?
And where is he? He's cruising down 95.
Where is he? That's not too local, Sam. That's a big road.
95.
We got a 95 right up here.
Could be 10, 20 miles long.
Brah!
Wait, what?
Rape.
Oh. Yeah.
But I'm saying, I bet the people listening are like, oh, man, I've cruised down 95 before. I love this show.
I know what he's talking about.
Yes. I'm familiar with that road, bra.
95 right now. He is my bra. Shut up.
He's my bra.
Stinks.
Come on, more laughs. I want to have more laughs.
Yeah, we need more
laughs. I want a mope wiser.
Dylan, who is cruising down 95. What's up, bra?
Nothing, man. On my way up.
Good. Liz in Port St. Lucie, how are you, Chicky Poo?
How are you, Chicky Lucy?
You know what he said? How are you, Chicky Poo? In Port St. Lucie.
That's right.
That's right.
This is fucking unbearable.
Home of spring training.
She's not a bra, she's a Chicky Poo.
Chicky Poo?
Chicky Poo. Oh.
You don't like Chicky Poo?
No, not unless... not unless a fucking little chick is standing on my chin, dropping something in my mouth.
Chicky Poo. Is that what he calls the girls?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
hey,
cool.
Chicky
guys
poo.
Of the bra.
Bras and Chicky
hey,
Poo.
Bra.
But he's got to be careful because his fiance is right there next to him.
That's right. Doing a little flirting on the phone.
Hey.
That's
a little crazy.
Hey, Chicky Poo.
That's something Randy's got to deal with. You know, Loper's kind of a hardcore metal guy, kind of hitting on the chicks. He's a man's man.
Yeah,
so.
Brah.
Randy. Chicky Poo.
Liz in Port St. Lucie, how are you, Chicky Poo?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, I'm chilling. You all are going to need mouth buzzers for this game. Lizard, what are you going to choose?
Liz.
Liz, all right. And Dylan, what are you going to go with, bro?
Crush.
Oh, gosh.
Crush. Liz, crush.
Look. Do the bit. And punt.
Yeah. I miss fucking Maxwell. I really
and
do.
Punt.
And punt.
Stupid-ass Maxwell.
I know. I've grown to like him, though. I don't know. I really shouldn't.
And punt.
And punt.
I miss that mess. That has to sleep with a mask. Fucking asshole.
He was a disaster, but at least he was fucking. He had the ability to be vicious. These guys are just terrible.
They're just
terrible. I'm saying he was at least an ornery kind of a prick. These guys are just terrible. He could be pretty mean.
This is awful. Bruh. This is fucking awful, brah.
Hey, ONA, it's really funny when radio shows condense their name LSR rules.
Oh, hey, ONA?
No, people call us ONA because they really don't want to say Opie. I don't even want to say Opie.
By the way, we never came up with ONA.
No.
Yes. That's the difference between natural branding and forced branding.
Yeah, like people just started with the fans. Saying ONA. Right.
No one's saying LSR live and local. Who yells that?
ALSR. Why? Shut up.
That's what Abner Louima yelled while Volpe was fucking with the plunger. LSR live and local. He just kept yelling it.
Did you notice that Loper called Liz Lizard?
Lizard.
I think I blocked that out. Childhood incident.
Cheeky poo.
Cheeky poo. What's up, Lizard?
Cheeky poo.
Some guy, what is it, Riker Redline, Rike Red? I don't know what your name is, but he says, who is this guy, Pauly Shore? Randy does her first dead guy. All right, finally we could get into the new bit called Guess What Dead Guy Randy's Doing.
Fun.
All right, so you know what you're listening for. Randy's going to do an impersonation. If you think you can nail that, well, buzz in and give us a dead celebrity.
Yeah, that's the key to the game. It's someone that's dead. And are you only doing 2009 dead people?
Yep.
All right, it's a Halloween spooktacular here on the Morning Buzz, and here we go. Guess what dead guy Randy's doing? Randy, kick it off.
I can sell ice to an Eskimo. I'm talking about my coke problem, people. Get clean with orange blow. I mean, glow.
Liz.
Last ride was on an airplane.
Liz is in with the guest. Go ahead, Liz.
Billy Mays.
Billy Mays, absolutely correct. Wow, Randy. That is an uncanny Billy Mays.
Thanks.
Absolutely incredible.
Please, can we have a Maxwell after that one?
Do the bit. And punt. Boozy, boozy, bop, city bop.
And punt.
Holy shit, who's listening to this?
You guys know. He does these impersonations. I swear, you'd think it was the real people.
This fucking stinks to high heaven.
Let's go to St. Louis. Jesse.
This is priceless. Mr. Aboo-boo-boo, Mother Hucker, and Big Daddy James and the guy who answers a fart are bashing these guys.
I only answered a fart once.
Yes.
It sounded like hello.
Yeah, you talked to it all the way home. You had to buckle up. Hey,
we're not
creep.
We're not saying we didn't have our bad haircuts over the years, but we got through it.
Yeah.
Exactly. Bad haircuts go. This fucking LSR is the equivalent of beheading.
It's the bold cut of radio we're listening to.
You guys know Billy Mays had a cocaine in his system, right?
Yes. I guess.
You did know that. I'm glad you clarified.
Yeah. Orange blow.
I knew it right when she said I could sell ice cubes to an Eskimo.
You got it then?
Yeah, because that meant he's...
I had it.
She was talking about a pitch man.
Yeah. Should have let your mouth buzzer go off.
There's only one pitch man that died in the last year, and his name is Billy Mays.
Ice cubes are never... No one fucking buys ice cubes anywhere.
No.
Hawaiians don't buy ice cubes. They make them for free.
Yeah, just tap water and ice tray.
Exactly.
The new game's going so well with these guys, they decided they needed to do another one.
Good.
No, this is the thing. It's best out of five.
Holy shit.
Yeah. I mean, it's not because, you know, anybody can have one lucky guess.
Fuck.
What's wrong?
Jamie from West Virginia has a very good observation. Jamie.
Happy birthday, Jimmy.
Thank you.
They're even keeping their dead guys local. I'm pretty sure Billy Mays was from West Palm Beach.
So they got to keep the dead guy local. Yeah.
Oh my God, please tell me that's what they were doing there.
Come on.
Let's continue.
Here we go, Dylan. You got to get in the game, man. Guess what dead guy Randy's doing for AFI tickets?
I got killed by a gunshot wound from my stupid ass girlfriend.
Steve McNair.
I'm the all-time leading passer.
Hey, Crush, Dylan, who's cruising down 95, is in. Go ahead, buddy.
Kurt Cobain.
Did not die anywhere near this year, my friend.
Are you stupid?
All-time leading passer?
He said it wasn't this year.
No, it is this year. In fact, it is this year.
The first one was Billy Mays, dude.
All right, go ahead, Liz in Port St. Lucie.
Steve McNair,
absolutely correct.
Port Liz, off to the early 2-0 lead.
Lizard.
Chicky poo.
What's just the bra was still cruising down 95?
Yeah. Bra.
Keep it local. This way they don't listen to the entertainment on satellite radio, the funny jokes or the good music. They want to hear the highway names.
Yes.
You assholes.
You're not a good hound. Are you trying to say you're not a good radio show unless you name highways?
That's what I listen for when I'm riding around. I don't want entertaining content. I want commercials and highway names.
All right. In that case, I want to say good morning to the Long Island Expressway.
Yeah. Wow.
L.I.E.
You got one?
I drove in on the Northern State Parkway, which becomes
which becomes the Grand Central.
Fucking A.
Drove in on that, and I just want to say hi to everybody I passed.
I want to say hi to everyone on the PCH.
Say hi to everyone from Washington Street to Christopher, back down around to Greenwich, and then back up around to Washington.
Oh, my God. Wow.
That's just a rectangle.
Really cruising around.
Trannies, yeah.
I want to say hi to everybody going to work right now on the old I-5 down there in Orange County. Yeah.
I'll just have to take your word for it.
You don't know so
I'm going local
I-5.
For California.
You know what I'm
going
to
I'll be on the 10 today.
I-5. You can be on the 10.
And the 410 because I'll go to L.A.
Burbank and stuff.
Let's say hi to the 202.
Oh, wow.
That's
look at
channel.
That.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And there's got to be a 202 out there somewhere.
No, but not the 202. The 202 is California. The. Whenever someone's you say that, it's L.A.
Yeah. I didn't say the 202.
The 5.
The 5?
The 10.
What about the 7?
5.
There's no 7.
You sure?
Positive. They had a 7, but it was stolen.
Randy does another dead guy. Then they tease the game will return tomorrow. This Fuck. Game is so good that they have to spend 2 days on it.
Well, they got more tickets to give away.
Guess what dead guy Randy's doing?
Hey, I got a drug problem.
Wait, Loper. OG Smitty.
I'm Jewish. I can spin pills on my turntables.
Uh-huh.
You know where I can score some meth? Anyone?
Can you just do that one more time, please? Liz is in.
Liz, I got a problem with drugs.
DJ AM.
DJ AM with the clean sweep. Guess what dead guy Randy's doing?
This is what I think should happen.
What's that?
You know how sometimes...
Wait, okay. He goes, this is what I think should happen. Maybe we should stop right there.
Fucking
maybe
bomb.
We should stop.
I was just thinking that.
Fall on the
maybe
stoop.
We should stop
a suicide
right
bomb. The fucking PD runs in with a bomb strapped to his chest. He yells, Allah Akbar, and falls on the console.
With a bomb strapped to his chest?
Yes. Yeah, same as a bomb. Dude!
Is he coming in today? Bobby's coming in today, right?
Did I say Bob?
Yeah, you did.
It sounded like Bob anyway.
You know what? They're live. They're local. Boom. Dude, you got your coffee. You got no listeners. Boom.
You named the highways.
Yeah, dude. You say the highways. Everybody knows where
come
you are.
Come up with pet names.
Yeah,
for
dude.
Your listeners.
You know what? The applause sounds busy. Boom.
Lopeizers.
Boom. Oh, yeah. Lopeizer.
And sweep. Guess what dead guy Randy's doing?
This is what I think should happen.
What's that?
You know how sometimes, like, when the comics come into town, you, like, introduce them at the improv?
Right.
I think Randy should do a solid 7 minutes of her impersonations of dead dudes.
It'll be back tomorrow, all the way till Halloween. Guess what dead guy Randy's doing?
How about what comics you won't introduce? Because they used to be on your station. Fritz and Randy.
Oh, they play music?
Yeah, they play a little music, too.
Yeah.
But they get to talk more than most shows do.
That's handy.
That's good.
Cool.
Because they got so much stuff to say.
Let me go to Jimmy James in New Hampshire. All the regulars checking in today. Jimmy James.
Morning, boys. Rapity, rape, rape.
Rapity, rape, rape.
I think we're being a little judgmental, passing judgment early. I think this bit has potential. I think we need to test it out with... guess what dead guy Ted Sheckler's doing?
Ooh.
I like that.
Wait. Let's get our spooky music. We got to do it like they do. Got to have a lot of production value behind your bit. We got any scary music so Ted could do this bit for us? Mm-hmm. Well, let's give it a second.
We should have
we weren't prepared for this.
Over this in some kind of post-show meeting or something.
All right, here we go.
Ah! I'm moonwalking with a hat and a glove.
Can I use my mouth buzzer?
You have to, yes, sir. I'm moonwalking. My sister LaToya. I have my finger on the bottom of a youngster. My father's hitting me again. I'm on fire. I have a Janet from Three's Company wig on and white children, which aren't mine.
Who is John Phillips?
That's excellent. A very good guess.
Fuck. All right, let's continue.
Who's Jocktober?
That's nice. The gang opens up the huge mail sack and read an email from a listener in quotes. What? You don't think it's a real fucking email? Are you questioning their fucking...
Let's just say that I had enough experience with Scorch's email bag that all were written by a similar person.
So Scorch had a fake email bag?
I think someone...
Why are you giving away Scorch's fucking tricks?
Let's just say...
He just wants to make it in that tiny little town.
Somebody's assignment in Syracuse was to go home and write emails for Scorch every single night.
Fucking Scorch. Radio stinks.
After my classwork.
So you had to write the emails for sports?
I wrote every single email for sports.
And what did he want from you? Like, some outrageous emails?
You know, and he wanted to, like...
You got an example of one?
Dear Scorch.
I could look them up in my old Gmail, I bet.
Love your show.
But I had to... I would think about what was happening on the show that morning when I got home. And then at night, I would say, hey, I was listening to the show this morning. And then I'd say either Scorch or his sidekick, Paulie, was so right... Da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Oh.
Love the show. Listen every morning.
Love the show.
What is he doing?
What is he doing?
Why don't you stop it?
Tell Scorch, love you, love the show.
So he didn't really get emails about his show?
No.
Not a lot.
Or I'd read an email that said, man, the brain cell stimulator was a real stumper this morning. Or once we got online listening, I would be from all kinds of different cities and say, hey, I'm in New York, but I listen online. Or
Oh, God.
I'm embarrassed to be in this business.
Poor Scorch. I actually have a Scorch. Paulie, who I'm still in contact with, who's very bitter.
Yeah. Why is he bitter?
Well, he always thought Scorch was a hack and was ruining his career. And eventually, Scorch did move and told him the night before his last show, by the way, Paulie, I'm moving after tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm moving tomorrow.
Even though throughout the whole time, Scorch said, yeah, I'm sending our tapes out. Don't worry about it, dude. So Paulie wasn't sending anything out. And then Scorch said, I'm going to New Hampshire tomorrow.
I'm leaving. What are you doing?
Yeah. So Paulie has some resentment there.
Yeah.
He emailed me last night. And said that he has a clip when Paulie and I were on Scorch's show of Scorch doing his Bill Cosby impression.
Oh, please.
Oh, I gotta hear that.
Do you have it yet?
No,
please.
I gotta get it. Paulie just getting pissed off. He said that Paulie was getting totally pissed off because he said it didn't sound anything like Bill Cosby. And I was in the background telling Paulie to shut his eyes because it seemed like Bill Cosby was in the studio with us.
He's sarcastic.
I would listen to that every day. Though.
Oh, it was such a great show.
Was it a good impression?
It was a great impression.
Did it sound like Bill Cosby?
It was fun to listen to.
Did it sound like Bill Cosby?
It didn't. It didn't sound anything like Bill Cosby.
Pudding Pops. Jello pudding.
Jello pudding pops.
Look, I'm a huckster.
Paulie used to get into the worst arguments because Paulie was so fed up with being on his show. And I would just sit there taking Scorch's side every time and writing emails about how stupid Paulie was.
What the fuck?
It was a great time in my life.
We're ready for some Scorch audio. It's been way too long.
It's been too long.
You've been slacking.
Maybe we'll highlight Scorch tomorrow.
Yeah.
Well... No, because that we don't need for Jocktober. That's already a bit we do.
Okay.
The Scorch update.
Okay.
Yeah.
But the Cosby thing, get that tomorrow.
Okay.
Gotta hear that.
Oh, my God. It laughed so hard my fucking mouth hurts. My jaw hurts right now.
Fucking Scorch, man.
The gang opens up the huge mail sack. That's in quotations because Sam knows a little bit about the huge mail sack. And reads an email.
Say that again.
And reads an email from a listener. That's in quotes because Sam knows that's a fake fucking listener email, which results in Randy and Loper talking about their wedding location.
That's good stuff. Come on now. You want to hear a guy and a girl planning their wedding on the radio.
Absolutely.
All right, let's look into the Morning Buzz huge mail sack, shall we? This one comes to us from Billy in Boynton. He says, what's up, Loper, Smitty, and Randy? How the hell are you?
What's up? What's up?
Guys.
No, he didn't.
I had to stop because before we move forward, I don't think we did the dead guy bit justice. Although Ted Sheckler was really good.
Of course.
Richard from Washington State has a great idea.
I know what it is. I was waiting for someone else to suggest it.
No.
Richard from Washington State has a great idea. And if he doesn't come in here, fucking Club Soda Kenny will drag him in here. By his fucking love handles. Richard!
Good morning, boys.
Hi, Richard.
Can we please hear what that guy, the virus, is doing?
let's get the virus in here. And
oh, my God, I'm sweating. This is such a good idea.
Get the virus in here, and let's hear him do a...
Well, we got to get his, do we go with his music or do we go with a Halloween theme for the virus today?
Oh, I love his music.
I like his music too.
His music is so
Kenny
perfect.
Has just marched down the hall to make sure that there's no shenanigans today and the virus gets his ass down here.
It's piggy music.
Here comes the virus.
Look, here comes the virus.
Everyone get their fucking cameras out. Here
you think he's happy to be coming down the hall?
No, not at all. Here he comes. We're all just watching him walk.
Here comes the virus.
He just flipped the bird to everybody in the room.
Yeah,
that's good.
Jimmy, he's happy to be here. Come on.
Virus hat. The virus. Here he is. Hey, it's the virus.
Hey, virus.
Here's the virus.
What's going on, virus?
Just comedy gold every time.
Virus, you know the bit we're doing today?
Yeah, I heard it, guys.
All right, you're going to do like a dead guy impression, and we got to figure out who you're doing, okay?
Yeah, who it is based on your subtle clues.
That's right.
Subtle. That you get. Very subtle.
Here we go. The virus.
All right.
I've done worse than kill you, Admiral. I've hurt you. From hell's heart, I stab at thee.
It's a... Oh, okay. I know who it is, but...
I don't.
It's like, can we get a little more?
It's a movie line.
Welcome to Fantasy Island.
He's doing impressions. Real subtle.
You're not supposed to...
I don't think you're supposed to do...
Like, describe yourself.
Yeah,
you're supposed
to
give clues.
You would say something more like, I sell cars with rich Corinthian leather as the seats. I was in a movie with William Shatner.
I wore a white suit.
You don't do the, you don't do the actual fucking lines.
I'm surprised we haven't learned. I'm not good at this.
Although I do appreciate a good Wrath of Khan quote.
Yeah.
Do another one. Who you got?
You should do a different one.
Yeah, I think so.
Ricardo
absolutely.
Montalban.
That's right.
I would need a dead guy. Some clues. Come on, clues. Go. Start.
All right, let's go. Here comes.
What clues you got? Let's go.
The virus doing the dead guy bit.
Come on, everybody, listen. What clues you got? Boom. Don't do Michael Jackson. We just did him. Boom.
Yeah.
Go.
The dead guy.
Come on. Who you got? Don't do Billy Mays either.
Here comes the virus.
I used to sell Alpo dog food. I might show up at your house with a really big check.
Well, you know, it ain't serious.
Yeah, I got that one, too.
I didn't get it. More
bad.
Clues.
That's not bad. Yeah, give more clues on that one,
I don't
virus.
Get it.
I got it, but keep going.
I don't get it.
I used to host Star Search.
It's supposed to be a clue.
Come on, who? Go. More clues.
I was known for my trademark laugh. Hey-o.
Roland Campos.
Would that be Ed McMahon virus?
That would be correct.
Cool. Good thing you didn't mention Sidekick for Carson.
Right.
Yes. Mention Alpo before the Tonight Show.
All right, get out.
Yeah.
Can we have one more, please?
No.
Come on.
He actually knows too much.
It took 40 minutes to get two out of him.
I know.
It stinks.
He does rot.
He rots.
Walk down the hall, he's not happy.
There he goes.
Yesterday, the virus told me this was the one bit that makes him think about taking his own life.
Oh, okay.
Out of all the bits that he's done.
Our listeners, so it's, you know why? Because it's an absolute validation of every fear that he has, that he's just a lump.
Did you know when the virus was a little boy, he wanted to be the host of The Tonight Show?
Did he?
What are you talking about?
That's
true. Actually said that?
I've been sitting on that one for a while.
You know what? We should have had him do some monologue jokes.
Oh.
God damn it.
Now, is this the virus or is this, E-Rock?
Young Sex Bagel, when he was growing up, wanted to be a late night talk show host.
Oof. He did he?
Like Johnny Carson.
Yeah.
The virus rules.
It's
my favorite thing right now.
Yeah, that's something.
All right, why don't we take a break and we'll continue with Jocktober with the Lopeweiser show from West Palm Beach, Florida.
Okay, it's LSR.
LSR.
Live and local.
Yeah, just add an O and an E and another S. Too much for the joke, I understand.
Wait, what?
Spelling joke.
Yeah, a little spelling joke for the spellers out there. All right, quick break. We'll continue with Jocktober. Stay there. Let's get back into Jacktober. Do we need another sweeper, or we just go into it?
Just go into it.
All right, let's do this. All right, second half of Jocktober. Bobby, if you want to sit out, we understand, you know. Yeah, we put some of you guys in bad positions because we know you got to do a lot of radio out there when you're trying to sell
Bob is
gigs.
Not bad-mouth these guys at all.
All right. But if you feel like doing it in fun.
I think I actually like these guys. They were nice to me.
Well, I'll just shut up. Jesus, Bob. Just sit down. Don't embarrass yourself.
Yeah.
The rest of it's good.
Are they bad?
Oh.
We just didn't like that one bit. Give the rest of it a chance.
All right, we'll do that, Sam. So we move on with Jocktober, looking at the show that replaced us down there in West Palm Beach, Florida. Loper, Smitty, and Randy on Florida's new rock alternative, Buzz 103.1.
Yeah. New rock alternative.
Great.
Yuck.
Talk, Sam. I got to figure out what mic's to turn off.
Alternative to good.
I'm talking into this.
All right,
turn me off. There, I'm back on now.
Take some of the noise out of the room. The gang opens the huge mail sack and read an email from a listener, which results in Randy and Loper talking about their wedding location. Now, Sam has told us here that there is no huge mail sack and there is no listener email. All this was made up for the purpose of them setting up talking about their own wedding for their radio show.
You can tell in the beginning of the email, the greeting is obviously written by somebody who works at the station because that's the exact greeting that I would start Scorch's emails with.
All right, perfect.
All right, let's look into the Morning Buzz huge mail sack, shall we? This one comes to us from Billy in Boynton. He says, "What's up, Loper, Smitty, and Randy? How the hell are you? Love the show. Listen every single day, and I couldn't help but continue to want."
What's wrong?
Self-serving.
What's wrong?
Crap.
You don't think that particular listener listens every day?
I'm surprised the listener didn't mention the call letters. Fucking assholes.
I love your live and local.
Yeah, I love the. What was
great.
It? What are they? LSR.
Yeah.
And would you ever write an email and actually, like, use the term, how the hell are you?
No.
No person would do that.
No. Listen to the email and then picture actually writing it.
Nobody would.
No one would do that.
I couldn't help but continue to wonder what Randy and Loper, outside of the crazy sex romp, got accomplished on their weekend to the Keys. That's Billy and Boynton. I guess he's referring to us going down to look for a wedding location.
Oh.
Like, he's wondering if we chose a location outside of our sex romp.
Did you guys succeed?
Which wasn't a sex romp, by the way, Billy, all right?
I don't know if we've really succeeded yet. We haven't, I guess.
So is it definitely going to be at the Keys, 100%?
I don't know that for sure. Ooh. I mean, I would say what, Ran, like 90%?
I guess 90%, yeah. You know? I mean, if anyone knows anywhere cool around here, you know, we're open.
So the 10% wouldn't be like something more crazy like Puerto Rico or Costa Rica. Nah. It'd be something more local.
Absolutely.
Wow. You know, listening to wedding planning is...
And you notice they had the local angle.
Of course they did.
Why would they open for the possibility that maybe they get married locally?
Local. Everything's got to be local.
Enough about the local.
Fuck the local.
We lost Jimmy. Christ. He can't handle this anymore. Well, he's done. He just walks out.
Why would you want to get married any place other than West Palm, Florida?
Yeah, that's true.
Well, yeah. All right. Well,
card the spot.
The wedding talk continues with no bit. They solicit calls asking for wedding locations. Holy shit.
I swear to God.
Yeah, this is good stuff now, I bet.
Attaboy.
Here we go.
Hope they get some funny ones.
Oh. You know, like, there's all kind of things people don't know. You know, it's cheaper to have a wedding on a Friday than it is on a Saturday.
Yeah, that is
Pause
true.
Pause that for why? A second. I did not know that.
It's true.
Yeah, I wonder why.
I don't know.
Fodder for conversation.
Yeah.
Have you ever been to a Friday wedding?
No.
Holy
I wouldn't remember. Who cares?
Yeah, what
gives a fuck?
Day it's on.
The church is at 11. Really?
Is it?
We have to work. Cocktail hour, 2 in the afternoon. Really?
That's probably
How about you spend a few bucks on your wedding and make it on a Saturday when we're all off?
My sister got married on a Wednesday.
Yeah, exactly.
I got a deal that she gets.
That's convenient.
I got married on a Tuesday.
See, that's just selfish.
I bopped it on the beach, though. At least he didn't drag us all there.
That's different. But
Sam's sister was just being fucking a total
piece selfish,
of shit.
Sam.
She got married in the city.
She just assumed that everyone wants to take a fucking vacation day to go to her wedding.
Yeah,
that's not
that
nice.
Day. And it was like, yeah, it was just what you said. It was early afternoon church into the reception,
right.
And then the reception goes to 1 o'clock in the
People
morning.
People count so their fucking vacation days on their one hand, and now they go, oh, great, I got to use one for someone's wedding.
But it wasn't even the Friday.
Not to, I don't know, do something fucking cool for the day.
Because at least on the Friday, if you go to the reception until 1 o'clock, you know.
Right.
But you do it on a Wednesday, you got to take off Thursday, too.
Right. Weekend.
Yeah,
terrible.
Right.
Your sister's awful. Don't ever talk about her again.
I met her, and she's so nice.
She's
but
not
still,
nice.
Sam, Jesus Christ, what was she thinking? That's not fair. What kind of deal did she get?
I don't know. I didn't pay for it myself.
50% off, I guarantee. Because who else is getting married on a fucking Wednesday?
I hope she only saved like $30.
Inconvenienced everybody.
I went to a wedding once. It was the day before like Christmas Eve. I'm like, really?
Yeah, it's an inconvenience.
You know, this is a busy fucking time of the year. I got last-minute shopping to do, and now I have to deal with a fucking wedding the day before
Christmas
Eve? Goddamn
Jewish people.
Jewish.
Were they Jewish?
No.
You know what? I want to get married, Gregory.
We're dead.
I want to get married on Groundhog Day so everybody can dress like Punxsutawney Phil. I love Punxsutawney Phil. I just want to go scoocha under his chin.
Yeah, scoocha. He's very vicious, that little fucker.
Oh, no, he's lovely. He loves me.
He bites people.
He nuzzle.
I got to talk vague, but in the spring, I'm going to a...
Uh-oh. Gay what?
Yes.
It's a Renaissance festival theme.
Oh, what, a wedding?
And everyone has to trust in character.
Why would you? I wouldn't do it.
I'm not even open my teeth.
Borrow Anthony's.
And
yeah, I have
exactly.
In the closet.
And on top of that.
You want a rapier?
This is going to drive you nuts.
A rapier.
This will drive you nuts. No alcohol at the wedding.
What?
That's
no mead?
That's is it called mead?
My lord?
Oh, I fucking hate that. I fucking hate it too.
Mead.
Excuse me, where's the bathroom? Why, will that be taking a bath? No, I have to, you know, go to the bathroom. Oh, you mean the privy? Shut the fuck up. Where's the portable toilet that the shit-sucking truck comes in? You know the Renaissance ye old shit-sucky truck? You fucking dork.
All right, look.
Ugh,
Danny has a picture up, and that's how they expect us to dress. They want us to dress in character.
You.
No, everyone.
Those are belly dancers.
Everyone has to dress in character.
Who's getting married? Get belly dancers up, you jackass.
Just someone in the family.
I have fantastic video that I have never even taken off the tape yet and put online. I have to fucking do this.
Titty porn?
It is. No! Oh. It is me, Danny, and Eastside Dave, and a couple of other people hammered off our fucking ass at the Renaissance Festival, throwing axes and those Chinese stars.
Oh, nice.
That's something that is, I mean, as much as you want to make fun of Renaissance
Dude,
fairs.
Axe tossing, I loved. I did it up in the Rochester area.
Dude, anywhere where you can
that
go
shit rules.
Where they give you sharp objects
Fuck
after
yeah.
you're completely drunk
hammered.
Is an awesome place to be.
We are hammered. I am dressed in full regalia.
Look, I went to a Renaissance Festival.
Looked like a tool.
I went once in Rochester. I had a great time. We got drunk, the big fucking turkey legs, you're throwing axes.
Yeah. I'd like the turkey legs.
You're looking
leg,
at the winches?
The rest of it sounds horrid.
No, you get
it wasn't that bad.
You get a yard of ale, and you drink that down, and the turkey leg, and then you throw axes, and then you watch people a sword fight.
Why don't you cut
with
the
their
shit.
Penises and
malarkey. Dock. Cut the malarkey.
Yeah, why don't you stand enough of this bunk.
Yeah, but the problem I have
I want to be a king. Want to dress in ye old fashioned.
You can't be the king, Ted.
But I want to be King Theodore III, finally respected and not slapped in the face and laughed at.
But they have a king. You are just there as part of the town,
oh.
the village.
Yeah,
so you know you could
a regular folk.
You could dress as like a.
I want to dress in ye old fashioned.
Well, you can
wear ye horse.
You could dress like a swordsman.
Oh, I wish to swashbuckle, Anthony.
Oh no, that's not a pirate.
Yes, it is.
But I've seen, there were a few Jack Sparrows there that were ridiculous.
Yeah, I don't understand how that works.
I think I saw a Klingon. Why was a Klingon at the Renaissance Festival? But I guess they're going to be a dork.
But do you think it's a bit selfish to say no alcohol just because that's their thing?
Yes.
That's not fucking fair. Yeah, and I'm not a big drinker, but you know what? I want a fucking few pops.
Hey, especially if you got to dress up. Are they going to make you do those dances that bring the ding 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 dancing when you get like four of you together and hold hands in the middle and go around in circles?
I don't know what they're going to do.
Who's going to dress like that and dance without being drunk?
Yeah, exactly. See,
I do respect that they're doing it different, and this is something they're into. I really do. But but to say, look, you know, we're not we don't like drinking, so no one gets to drink, is that's just not fair.
No, it's not. Bring your own. Well, bring ye old drinking flask.
You don't think we're all figuring that out now?
I would fucking have a...
Are you kidding me?
Ye flask on the side.
It's going to be a fucking tailgate.
Jack Daniels.
There's going to be a tailgate party going on.
Put it in ye pocket, Gregory. I'll smite ye.
Don't be smiting.
Why would you swing a medieval mace around. I attack people with it. I want to be respected like King Arthur.
We need some lute music for...
lute?
For Ted Yee.
Ye old Ted.
Glad we're talking about weddings. See, this is how they should have talked about weddings. The fucking selfish fucks like Sam's sister.
Wow.
I like her too, Sam. I'm sorry.
It's
your mom
true,
listening
though.
Today? She's going to
my mom did listen
me.
Every day.
I'm but, sorry, Sam's mom.
It's okay. She was very inconsiderate.
She is, right?
To have the wedding in the middle of the week was
I hate that bitch.
Okay, well, you don't even know her.
Sam felt so uncomfortable that he couldn't even really take days off for his own sister's wedding. Even he felt like, I can't do this. I could give you maybe a half a day.
Yeah, I didn't take the day of the wedding off.
No.
But that's me, though. I don't take days off.
Right.
You know, I don't do that.
And people that get married
dedicated.
On a Friday before a 3-day weekend, what the fuck? That is just selfish shit. Get a better job and get some fucking money in your bank account and do it the right way.
That's right.
A Saturday in the middle of just a who gives a shit weekend.
In the summer, so it's warm.
No, I want my summer weekends off, too.
In the winter, so yes. It's cold.
Yeah, because most... Yes.
Yes.
For real.
Yes.
Let's get back to Loper.
And do you know, like, there's all kind of things people don't know. You know, it's cheaper to have a wedding on a Friday than it is on a Saturday.
Yeah, that is true. And
why?
I don't know.
Let's go over these things, all right?
That's
there's
random.
A lot of things maybe you don't know. You ask some questions, Smitty will answer the questions.
I have a vote.
What's that?
I think you should have the wedding at that one underwater hotel you were showing me the other day, Randy.
That is cool.
That is the coolest thing I've ever seen in my life. It's underwater, just 20 feet underground.
I would love it. My mama.
Isn't that awful thing we talked about?
Where's
and
that?
We actually spoke to a woman that worked there.
Is she listening today?
And said it was
She'll tell you how cool that horrible underwater hotel thing is all about.
Mildew, drippy, fucking stinking rust bucket.
Smells like Chinatown on a hot summer's day.
It's not a hotel.
With all that shit that's rotting that they're trying to sell us.
It's a bed in a fucking 55-gallon drum underwater.
Right.
How do you get out of there? Is there steps or is there a sub?
You got to, I think, swim in and through an airlock in the bottom.
No, they don't want that. No.
Yes, you got to go down and swim.
There's a little tunnel thing.
You got to swim.
But you don't.
No, you swim.
I don't think so.
Swear to you.
Do you drag your luggage?
Yeah, how do you get your luggage down?
I know.
Oh, didn't she say they put it in plastic or something?
How do you get your luggage?
I don't know.
Could she call back down there?
She was a favorite phone call of ours.
But you can only take so much because like luggage won't even fit through the airlock thing.
All right, let me go to Stryker and hopefully that
Stryker
woman will call and answer all our questions. Stryker,
morning, boys.
Hey, buddy.
Who do you love? You love the show. Anyhow, I'm going to a Halloween themed wedding this Saturday. My neighbor across the street, they're like really into horror films and whatnot, and they're getting married this weekend, and it's Halloween themed. They're expecting everybody to be in costume, and I just told them no.
That's not as bad though, dude. Because it's like a Halloween party, that's not as bad. Because the reception's like
it's
a party.
Not a Halloween party.
What's that?
It's not even a Halloween party. In fact, the reception later on, you don't have to be in costume for the reception. The invitation actually said that. I'm like, then why the fuck do I need to dress up?
They should dress up like fucking Scott and Lacey Peterson. That'd be funny wedding costume. Or Jake and Vicky Labata.
Hey, Jimmy, I got one for you. for Uncle Paul. I saw a daycare center yesterday. The name of it is called Hugs and Tugs.
Yeah, Hugs and Tugs. I know that place.
Hugs and Tugs.
They rejected my application.
I bet.
I saw it yesterday, and I thought of Uncle Paul and just cracked up laughing. It's a perfect place for him.
I'm glad you
did.
Uncle Paul rules.
Hey, Stryker, thank you, buddy. Danny, I think we're on the same page today. I like this. I saw that shark thing you put up there. We're going to get to that. A fucking shark bit another fucking shark. That's how fucking evil these sharks are.
Yeah, pretty nasty.
You got to see the chunk that the one shark took out of the other shark.
What do you think?
You saw that shit yesterday?
Shark eat shark world out there.
Yeah.
Huh? Oh, that's where it came from.
Oh, huh? No wonder you're not on a plane anymore.
Whoa. Yeah. I'm actually in this studio.
Yikes.
Yeah, you've been demoted back to our show. Here we go. More wedding talk.
Underground.
I would love if my mama could go, Smitty. She's 88. How is she going to scuba dive down to the bottom?
My granny, my papa.
Wedding survivor.
Yeah. No.
Sorry, mama. Get in the pool. Michael Phelps it up a little bit.
550-9103, toll free, 866-954-ROCK. Hey, where should Randy and I get hitched? We'll take your suggestions coming up next.
Oh, come on. Yeah.
What? Out of all the phone topics you can do?
Yes. They have decided that what they're going to do with their day is spend an hour, and yes, they spent an hour.
They spent an hour on this?
Talking about where they're going to get married locally.
Holy shit.
Not exotic places, not crazy fun places, but just different venues in West Palm Beach and the surrounding area that could facilitate a wedding.
Well, the next track, they actually start taking calls, with wedding location suggestions. So they're actually doing it, Ann.
Tiffany in West Palm Beach, hello.
Hey guys. I wanted to wish you congratulations first off.
Thanks, Jeff. Appreciate that.
My friend is getting married at the Addison in Boca Raton in January, and it is absolutely gorgeous.
What is it? Say it again.
Boca.
It's the Addison.
The Addison, kind of like the Madison without the M?
Yes.
Right. And it's in Boca. And
the Boca
have,
Vista.
They have these big oak trees in the middle that they light up for you. It's
really?
Absolutely gorgeous. Yeah, you should check it out.
Big oak trees, huh?
I like that.
I like how she says that. It's really gorgeous. It's in Boca.
I'm from Louisiana, and we have huge oak trees full of moss and stuff, and that makes me think of home. So that's pretty interesting.
No, it's not.
It's the polar opposite of interesting. It couldn't be less interesting, actually.
I would bet money they already know where they're being fucking
of
married.
Of course they do.
But why spend so much time? It's like when you hear your loved ones talking about their wedding, you want to kill yourself because it's boring.
Oh, is that what happened with your sister getting married recently?
Yes, I told
her. You didn't like the fucking marriage talk?
Every time I went over to my parents' house, all they were talking about was the wedding. And they're related to me. I don't need to hear an hour of strangers talking about it.
All right. Hey, Justin has another.
That is fun.
Yes, go ahead, Justin. Tampa.
Keep it local. I live down in Florida. And down south, you know, college football is huge. And I hate when people want to get married on a big college football weekend. I went to the Clemson-Miami game this past weekend and was invited to a wedding and just told them no because I was going to this game.
Well, it's funny you should say that, because someone told me probably 3 days ago, they had to go to a christening. And this person that was having their baby christened, female, big football fan, christening on a Sunday, two days ago. She looked at the fucking football schedule and said, well, my favorite team's not playing this Sunday, so this is a perfect day for a christening.
Ah.
And the thought is, well, other people's favorite fucking football teams are playing this Sunday.
That's selfish.
Yeah, why would you go to a loving ceremony with family when you can watch a bunch of guys throwing a ball?
Dude, but that shit but you could plan that shit around fucking big football weekends.
I know.
Because then you get everyone crowding around a dumb, tiny little TV because someone figures out how to smuggle a little, you know, black and white TV
into
in.
Church.
Exactly.
Or, well, not the church, but obviously, but anywhere else.
You put it on the back of the Moyle's head when he fucking sucks the blood off the baby's penis.
Jesus.
Yeah. Fucking barbarians.
It's true.
The kid's foreskin alone.
Interesting enough, you can't use portable televisions outside of the house anymore with the digital conversion.
Oh, fuck, really?
You can't just, you know, put up the old antennae, the rabbit ears.
Oh, wow. I had no idea.
Yeah.
You'll get one station. It's
no
kind of like...
kidding.
Yeah, emergency. It's like a nuclear holocaust channel, yeah, basically.
If that one comes on, you're fucked.
You're fucked. It's like a loop saying that the reason why you're not watching TV is because everybody else has digital.
It's the one channel like Jordy Verrill was watching when he fell asleep in front of the television.
Yeah, they just played a Star Spangled Banner and a Test Banner.
Yeah. All right, I was out of that one. You got to help me out.
Yeah. Creep Show.
Fuck, see, I got to watch Creep Show. You guys reference Jordy that one a lot.
I'll bring it in for you if I can remember.
Can you? Because I like Danny's movies.
Meteor Shit.
I finally saw The Prestige because of Danny.
Excuse me, I'd like to get back to the laughs, please.
Oh, okay. Sorry, Jimmy. More wedding suggestions. Here we go. Jacktober continues.
Nick and Fort Pierce, you're next. Go ahead, man.
How's it going?
Going well. If you say Fort Pierce, I'm going to say going bad.
No, I'm driving through, going to work.
Okay.
There's a spot down in Key Largo called Snooks by the Bay.
Snooks by the Bay. Now, how many we haven't checked that out yet. Snooks by... Is there all you can handle snook fishing?
I would imagine there is.
Oh, no.
Good.
It overlooks the bay. Actually, there's a website you can go on to and check it out.
Well, when we're planning on getting married, we'll actually be out of snook season, so that's a bummer.
Yeah. Well, then we can get married there, actually. That's fine.
Sorry I missed your wedding, guys, but I got a 3-foot snook.
Hey, let me ask you something. That'd be impressive.
Who the fuck looks forward to this in the morning? Who runs out to the car to hear this fucking shit?
I love the genuine anger that Jimmy, that pops up in Jimmy.
I don't get it.
It's just genuine anger.
I don't fucking get it.
Well, walk through it. You wake up and you're running to your fucking radio. You can't wait to get involved.
Ooh, they're
right,
on.
Right.
Yeah. LSR Live and Local.
Local and
what
vocal.
Is it? Local,
whatever it
live,
is.
Live, local, and vocal. And vocal.
Get me a Lopeweiser, somebody quickly.
Oh yeah.
Where's my Lopeweiser?
Here you go, Jimmy. Here you go.
That's right, Serge.
I got it right here for you, right now.
Icy cold.
Yeah, pop the fucking tap in your mouth and work those balls. Get a nice Lopeweiser.
Blowjob joke.
Yep, got it.
Eric,
Kidoki.
What do you got for the show?
Boo.
Where are you calling from, so we can be local?
I'm calling from Maryland.
Oh, cool.
Not local enough. What part of Maryland?
Frederick, Maryland.
Not local enough.
Come on.
Ah, my friend's from Elkton.
Frederick, New Design Road.
Not local enough.
Your home address.
Just what room are you in my house?
All right, Eric.
We actually need the plot number that goes on your property tax.
Jesus.
So you can really narrow it down.
Let's really run the local bit into the ground. Give your specific location.
And you can look at me on Google Maps.
What's that worst phone ever?
No, this is. Not too annoying, huh?
God, that is really fucking annoying.
My phone does that.
It doesn't take much to entertain you, does it?
No, you guys. What did you just hand me?
A fart.
Oh, yeah, he just blew a fart over to you.
It's a cup of fart.
Oh, no, he just ate cat food.
Yeah, it doesn't even smell. It smells like like meat.
Let me go to Eric. Go ahead, Eric.
I was saying my brother had his daughter's baby naming at 9 a.m. on New Year's Day.
Wait, his baby naming is an event?
It's a Jewish thing, I believe. Jewish ceremony, right?
Yeah.
What is that all about? I don't really know.
What is that?
Burden. The rabbi takes your daughter, says a blessing over, announces her Hebrew name, and that's pretty much it.
Ugh.
But they have to have a whole service.
And they decide to do it 9 a.m. New Year's Day? Yes. That is the most fucking selfish thing I've ever heard.
What fucking nerds?
What the fuck?
Why don't they cut it out?
Hey, why don't you cut it out?
Yeah, call your kid whatever you want.
Yeah.
Just don't call your kid late for supper.
Oh, shit.
Do the bit.
Oh, shit. All right, Eric, thank you.
Supper.
I guess you get the point, huh? This guy used to work at Larkfield Manor Inn. That's a little local knowledge for fucking Long Island, huh?
Yeah.
Larkfield
Manor. If I'm not mistaken, that's right by the corner of, like, Larkfield Road and, I believe, Clay Pits.
Tom?
Yes, sir.
See, I was talking to you. There's a 7-Eleven there, right? And a gas station on the other corner. Yeah.
And I believe there was a supermarket and a Genovese up the road a little ways.
King Cullen across the street.
King Cullen, yes, Opie. A King Cullen. I'm just trying to keep it local, live, and lousy. That's what I'm fucking doing here.
King Cullen is the fucking worst supermarket.
I am King of Cullen.
Why don't you like King Cullen, Jimmy?
It's fucking horrendous.
King Cullen.
I'd rather fucking eat out of Prince Dumpster than go to King Cullen.
King Cullen.
King Cullen.
Yeah, where did that come from?
It's fucking awful.
Danny, find out where King Cullen originated.
There's a worse one.
What?
Wallbaum's.
Well, at least you know some Jewish guy was like, hey, I'm going to open a supermarket.
Anything with a silent D should be fucking blown up.
I'm not sure.
Waldbaum.
I think you got to sneak that D in a little bit.
We used to just call it Wallbaum's.
Yeah, Wallbaum's. Hey,
it's Wallbaum's. But, yeah, King Cullen. These are, if you're on the West Coast, you know, these are the same things as Vons and Safeway. To keep it local.
Not
for
as
them.
Good, though.
Vons. Why?
What's an awful one? C-Town is always in the ghetto.
C-Town.
C-Town
and
rules.
Key Food. Key Food's always in a pretty much a shithole, too.
Key Food.
Oh, sorry, Danny. Is one near you? you're nodding your head like, yeah.
He lives above one.
We're not too far away.
Key Food's sucking ass.
Key Food is fucking terrible.
But King Cullen.
King Cullen. I'm the manager at King Cullen. Can I help you?
Remember Bohack?
Bohack.
No.
There was a supermarket named Bohack.
On Long Island?
No.
Yes, Bohacks.
I'm still looking for a Two Guys. I have to return some trousers
two
I got
guys.
In 1980.
Bohacks.
All right, Tom, what do you got on Larkfield Manor?
When I used to work there, and I was up to maybe 8-9 years, every Super Bowl Sunday, we never once had a wedding because people would come in and they would, you know, they're booking their weddings a year in advance, whatever. And they might not know the date, but we always had it in the book that that was the Super Bowl. And I remember one couple in particular that came in to book their wedding and told them, look, it's Super Bowl Sunday. So they took the following week instead because they know people just aren't going to show up.
Well, they're being nice.
Exactly.
They're not thinking of just themselves.
That was one day. I didn't have to ask to pay bucks. I knew I wouldn't be working.
Holy shit, really? Can we say that we're talking to her? Why? All right.
Snay.
We got something going on nice right now. Hey, thank you, Tom.
And Jimmy, I love your book.
As you should have.
I thought it was excellent.
Yes, it was. Stop kissing my ass. Thank you, sir.
We got to get that done. That's huge.
I know. Thank you, buddy.
All right. I'm sorry. John in Jersey. John.
Hope it fails.
Hi, John from Red Bank, New Jersey on the Navisink River. How are you guys?
Welcome. Very close to the Count Basie Theater.
It's amazing.
I don't know.
On Super Bowl Sunday in 2000.
Fucking through.
What? Fucking cup.
Wait, I think he said his wife's cousin was married on Super Bowl Sunday.
Wow.
Is there anything more fucking selfish than that? That is the number one selfish thing ever.
He was Russian, and she's a freak retard. They dress up for Renaissance festivals, and I was the only one that seemed to be bothered.
Really? You would think more people would be bothered.
Even if,
maybe they didn't care.
Your phone sucks, brother.
Yeah, so that
sorry
really...
What you, that.
What's your phone made out of? Fucking paraffin and tinfoil? Your phone fucking eats my ass.
Kevin in West Hampton.
Paper and a comb.
Kevin, West Hampton.
Stupid.
He's got the history of King Cullen
for
everybody.
Oh, thank goodness.
Who does?
Kevin. What's up, Kevin? What do you know on King Cullen?
It's the family name is Cullen. They spelt it with a C, but when they put it together for the, I guess, you know, 2K, King Cullen.
What?
Why King?
You got me on that one.
But that's the whole thing I want to know.
We assumed Cullen was a name.
Yeah.
We didn't think it was a fucking political ideology.
Would I give a shit if Cullen changed it from C to K?
Exactly.
Thanks a lot, guys. Appreciate it.
All right, thanks.
Kevin from West Hampton, by the way.
For someone that has the history of King Cullen, he didn't have much history.
No. Nothing.
All right, let's get back to this. So we go back to Loper, and they're still talking. Wow, you put this in caps, Sam. So
yes.
That means you got anger. You got mad. They're still taking wedding location suggestions.
Cool.
Let's go to Mike on the Turnpike. Good morning, Mike.
Hey, good morning.
What's up, dude?
I'm with that guy that said Schnooks, but... Just to the south of that, like mile marker 100, is the Key Lime Sailing Club. It's like little cottages right on the water.
Okay.
Full efficiencies, and it would probably, you know, probably accommodate maybe 30, 40 people staying the night there. And every room comes with a sailboat.
Oh, what? Really? Oh, that's ridiculous. Oh,
it is so cool.
What is it called? Key Lime?
Key Lime Sailing Club.
Sailing Club. See, this is what I like.
You can find it on the internet.
No, you don't.
Now, the rooms are beachy, so it's, you know, nothing matches, and it's kind of, you know, whatever, but it's really nice. And
yeah,
it's
that's
very
where
nice
they're going for their wedding.
I'm happy if my hotel comes with a chocolate Andy's mint on my pillow.
Yeah, this guy's low budget.
Get it? Stop it.
Who wants a sailboat with their room?
Yeah. What the fuck?
Who the fuck wants a sailboat?
Well,
Smitty.
Can we finish
Smitty,
this?
Smitty, right?
Yeah.
Can we stop now, Sam?
Actually, no.
Please?
No, because we have not properly highlighted
they come out,
Smitty and
well,
Randy.
This is good. They come out of the horrendous wedding talk with Smitty's soapbox. What's this about, Sam?
This is like a ripped-off Fezzatorio done extremely poorly.
Oh, it's like he's up on his soapbox.
Yeah, he's sounding off about whatever it is that's got him riled up, and this week it's The Price is Right.
It's cool.
He's mad at The Price is Right?
Why not? It's fucking very relevant.
Why is he mad at The Price is Right?
Well,
don't spoil it, Sam.
Something he saw on the hit TV show The Price is Right got him riled up.
All right, hold on. Larry King wants in. We haven't heard from Larry today.
Larry.
We got Larry King audio for real. Hulk Hogan was on. It was just horrendous.
Correct.
Larry, what do you got today, buddy?
Good morning, my boys. I once went to a wedding at 1 in the afternoon on a Saturday in June. Questions, comments?
What?
What happened?
How important is time when I'm wasting it?
A boo.
A boo is right.
It's getting a booze.
I got to take the blame for that.
Why, you thought it was good?
Yeah, I fucking failed miserably.
Aw.
Larry King's usually a hit on our show. Here's Loper and his soapbox thing.
God.
Smitty's soapbox.
Smitty's soapbox.
So who's Smitty?
Loper and Smitty.
Oh.
He's the proverbial third wheel in the gang.
All right.
It is 8:16 here on the Morning Buzz, and time for Smitty's soapbox. Y'all ready for this? We are, sir.
Jimmy.
You guys hear the
Jimmy.
It's the Doogie
Howser.
Your face
is in your hands. You all right?
Embarrassed.
This is horrible.
Smitty's going to tell it like it is.
Oh, the fake. I'm sick of the applause sound effect.
Yeah, fuck. How many times?
How much clapping do they need?
Stop it.
And it's bad applause, too.
Self-congratulatory douchebags.
Just to make up for the fucking awful silence in the room.
That's what it is. Cover up the dead air.
It is 8:16 here on the Morning Buzz, and time for Smitty's soapbox.
Smitty's.
Y'all ready for this? We are, sir.
Yes.
If by chance you ever happen to find yourself on the Price is Right Showcase Showdown and are at first offered a dinette set and trip for two to Mexico City,
right?
You need to tell Drew Carey to shut up and pass that ish to the slightly overweight college girl standing next to you.
Always, man.
Because you know, and I know, and everyone knows, that within that next showcase lies a somewhat mediocre 2009 Pontiac. You need that somewhat mediocre 2009 Pontiac. And look what we have here. The slightly overweight college girl just bid $36,000 on the dinette set. Now do us all a favor and bid $1 so you can drive that Pontiac right into the heart of your dreams. Meanwhile, the dog you've had for 2 years, which you never got around to neutering, just humped every stray hussy on your street.
Uh-huh.
I always knew you were a jerk. The end. Smitty. I need like a love Smitty balls or something so you know when they're officially over.
Well, that's over. Whoa. And I like that, man.
How about
holy shit. Wait, Jimmy, before you say anything, I think you got stiff competition for that fucking uninvited guest thing you're doing for Leno.
I should just change the name.
Right.
To fucking, what was it called?
Jimmy Soapbox.
Shitty Soapbox.
Shitty Soapbox.
Shitty Soapbox.
Did you know
what did he say about we need a sound effect to know when it's over? Usually, if you got really good material, the listeners know when it's over.
How about this sound effect?
Because they've had their share of lofts.
Yeah. Here's the sound effect for them.
Did you hear when he said, pass that ish? You know what ish?
Oh, no, what?
I tapped out way before that.
Well, it was actually in the very beginning.
Oh. Pass that.
Right. Tapped out anyway.
Pass that ish?
What's an ish?
See, in hip-hop lyrics on the radio, a lot of times they'll play the curse words backwards instead of beeping them out. So a lot of the funnier talk programs nowadays will say ish instead of shit.
Oh, I got it.
It's a sort of a hats off to you okay. type of thing. So that's kind of just...
Very good. Shut up, you fucking tnuck.
Okay.
Exactly. You tunk.
That's what I just kind of said.
Oh, really?
Tnuck. See, it's T-N-U-K. Oh,
I said tunk.
Yeah, you said tongue.
Which would have been knut.
You oh. suck at that.
Oob. Oob.
Jesus.
Those are backwards.
By the way, Bobby took a break. He's going to be back in studio in about 15 more minutes. So.
Yeah.
What happened?
I don't know. He left. He didn't want to be part
I gotta
of this.
I got to leave.
What the fuck? What do you mean you got to leave? We got one more fucking track, oh, Jimmy.
I'll hear the other track.
All right. Oh, the gang left. Says goodbye.
Oh, cool.
The gang says goodbye for the morning.
Hope it's the same way fucking Steve McNair and his girlfriend said goodbye. Get it?
Yeah.
Or the old the old Phil Hartman send off.
You want the virus to do
it? Bill Shatner's wife.
Yeah, exactly. The old fucking Lou Costello kid.
Hey, take it easy, glub glub.
Oh, that's funny. Hey, Tommy, could you babysit? Rock and roll!
Yeah, man, I'll keep an eye on the kid.
Hey, what the Oops. Fuck was he doing that day?
Exactly. Not checking the skimmers.
No kidding.
Jesus.
What have we got in here?
Who have we got in here?
Here we go. Let the Lopeweiser say goodbye.
All right. Absolutely. Randy, tell the world that we'll see him tonight at Roxy's.
Everyone, the world. I'm sorry, not everyone. The world will be at Roxy's tonight. Don't take Florida for granted.
And Smitty, you want to bid everybody farewell?
Don't take good music for granted.
That's right.
Come to Roxy's tonight, 9 o'clock. Have a cocktail with me.
All right, and guys. And you. Here's a icy cold one, man. Lopeweiser for everybody getting through the workday. We'll see you tonight. There it's 9:48. Jason Davis up next.
A fucking icy cold Lopeweiser.
Icy cold Lopeweiser. Finishes up the show nicely.
Well, get you through the workday.
Well, guys, that should finish up the show.
Yeah.
But E-Rock just brought in a bonus track.
A hidden track.
And as much as we like to beat up E-Rock, we fucking should be patting him on the back today.
Sure.
We could all at the same time. There'd still be room.
Exactly. Oh, I think you said patting him on the back. It's already been done.
E-Rock just brought in a...
What's he choking on that we have to pat him on the back?
Exactly.
It's a minute.
Oh, look, it's a leg. It's Bo Derek's leg.
Jesus.
It's from Orca.
Yeah, that's an Orca reference. Very good. Holy suck, by the way. Fucking hated Orca.
How the fuck did you get that one?
Ah, shit.
That's brilliant.
He's implying that E-Rock is as big as a killer whale.
I know. I think E-Rock got it, Anthony.
Oh, I'm
sorry.
He didn't
have to rub it in that much. I think he really got it.
He really got it to them.
All right. E-Rock, what'd you bring in? Why don't you explain this? This is going to be a big douche chill.
I was trying to figure out if this engagement was real, because on her MySpace is a bunch of photos with her and her, I guess, ex-boyfriend, and there really wasn't anything with her and Loper.
Huh.
So I was digging through, and they had some audio on their website that that Loper proposed to her on the air. So it sort of explained what happened to the ex, that she broke up with that guy to start dating Loper.
Yeah.
And he does the full proposal on the air. And
this is a bit.
Well, I think when something might be mentioned during the proposal.
So they're not engaged, you don't think?
I think this is some kind of weird bit.
No, it's real, I swear to you.
Yes, they're going to be married at the Fisherman's Hiatus.
Steve, can you get Corey on the phone for us, please?
Yes. Here he is. He's got the accent.
They're going to be married at Tettelbaum's Wharf. You idiot.
I just spoke with him on the phone.
Yes. It's in Ohio. It's south of Cleveland, about 1,200 miles in Texas. Thank you, blithering idiot. Yes. Barack Obama's doing a tour. Would you like to get him in studio?
Yes. Guys, a couple of pitches here. A couple. Do you want Bill Clinton?
Yeah.
No, we can't get him. Barack Obama, no. Neil Armstrong.
we could possibly get Sandy Kane or Pope John Paul before he died. But I can't remember the new Nazi's name. Pope Richard Widmark. That's who he looks like. What's the, I got to hear the bonus tracks. I have to leave. I have to go catch, right, catch a silver airship.
Let's do this. Here we go.
Can I just do something real quick?
I would love if you did
something.
I just want to say this,
you know, like, to all the Buzz listeners out there, I want you to look high in the sky right now. I want you to look towards the ocean, especially if you're around 45th Street, 995.
More local.
More local. That is fucking
you dopes.
Keep it local, guys.
Listening to your PD is going to get you nowhere, you stupid dopes.
Who wouldn't know where the fucking ocean is? You're surrounded by it in Florida. Yeah. Look everywhere but north, right, you dope. Fucking assholes.
Anthony and I had to play by the rules for a little while, but then we realized that it was a bunch of horse shit, so we started breaking the rules. But all these other shows are not brave enough to do that. Stop listening to your PD about the local shit. It ain't going to get you anywhere.
That reminds me of the title of my new book, Rules, dot, dot, dot. Who's got 'em?
Can I just do something real quick?
I would love if you did something.
I just want to say this, please. You know, like... Oh, yeah. To all the Buzz listeners out there, I want you to look high in the sky right now. I want you to look towards the ocean, especially if you're around 45th Street, 995. And Randy, I want you to look in front of 45th Street, 995. And if you're on the webcam, Randy Razor, I love you more than anyone I've ever loved in my whole life.
Oh.
And, you know, with that being said, I love you more than anybody I've ever loved in my whole life. And I want to know if you'll marry me.
Yes. Absolutely, we'll marry you. I can't believe you have my name on a plane. It just flew by on the sky. You have my name on a plane.
If you look up in the sky right
now.
How great would it be if the plane crashed right into that studio? How great would that be? Fucking hot.
That
and they need dental records to identify them.
Fuck. That proposal was fucking terrible. He said the same thing twice. I love you more than anybody I've ever loved in my life. And
he said it twice.
Yeah.
I love you. Now look up in the sky to see the ocean. What?
I want you to look up in the sky so you can see the plane flying by.
Flew by on the sky. You have my name on a plane.
If you look up in the sky right now. Here, let me put the ring on your finger.
I gave him the wrong hand on accident.
What? You guys will see a little banner in the sky. And Brandy, you want to read the banner to everyone?
Okay, he keeps going by. It goes, Randy, will you marry me? Heart Loper.
Where's the
103.1 FM. If plane keeps going circling
it's
around our building.
Hold on. It's got the call letters on it.
Yeah, and you listen to the sales guys,
frequency on it.
Your
proposal has the fucking radio station
you
on it.
Fuck, you bartered your own fucking proposal. Yeah, yeah.
Well, sales is going to have to work this out.
Yeah, we just,
with
you know.
The plane.
If you agree to this, we just got to put the call letters on there. And then if you could thank the company at the end of your show for doing this.
I can't read it because the sign is going straight up and down. Pilot John Denver doesn't seem to be doing this right. How great would that be? Oh, look, our sign is somewhere in the ocean on the way to Hyannisport. Poor Johnny Jr. and his fucking banged up foot didn't do too good. Nice throttle, Dick.
Loper.
Where's the
103.1 FM. If plane keeps going circling around our building, do we have like clearance?
That guy blew the bit, by the way. Where's the plane? I want to see it.
Yeah, yeah.
They made it sound like it was right outside the window, obvious to everybody. And then that fucking idiot with his dumb improv fucked up the whole bit.
He was probably distracted by the balloon with two jocks in it dropping brassieres.
All right. Jesus. You have to remind everyone.
You guys are fucking crazy. Yeah! That was madness.
We're flying a zeppelin.
Do the bit.
Oh, douchey chills.
Good job, E-Rock.
Wait, there's a little more.
Heart Loper.
Where's the
103.1 FM. If plane keeps going circling around our building, do we have like flight clearance for this? I'm in shock. I make jokes when I'm in shock, and I'm in shock right now.
We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back, South Florida.
I'm getting married.
I'm crying.
Yeah, so are the listeners.
Holy shit.
Exactly.
That is such a fucking...
Yeah!
It's a radio bit. It's a fucking fake radio bit engagement thing.
They're hoping to get some talk.
Yeah.
Some water cooler. What is it called again?
Water cooler talk. Yeah. My agent says that sometimes. It seems like a little chatter starting. I have to hang up on Pete. Like, if you say chatter again, I'm firing you.
Chatter.
No one says chatter.
I miss Pete.
I miss Pete too, until he says chatter. Right. These fucking awful ideas. I love Pete, but he comes up with some of the fucking worst suggestions ever.
Take a wrench and hit him in his teeth when he says that.
His awful fucking mock turtlenecks.
He has no sense of fashion whatsoever.
Pete, if you're listening, your outfits stink.
Hey, suck a dick.
I forget what the other shirts he wears, but Jonathan always teases him because my fucking awful manager, Jonathan, always has IJBL. He has his initials on his fucking pocket, which is also the sign of an ass.
I don't think there are windows in that studio.
I don't remember.
Yeah, right.
You're a great find, man. Great find.
That was really moving.
Oh, fucking. I got those goosebumps, man, as I was listening to that.
That is so douchey.
That was pretty
fake
bad.
Fake radio proposal.
I don't know about that, Anthony. I don't think it's fair to say
fake
that.
Fake radio proposal.
When is Eastside Dave, speaking of fake wedding shit, going to admit that it was all a bit?
Yeah, that's
is that
problem.
Coming soon?
It actually wasn't. And the pregnancies, both of them were real as well.
Well, when he does a bit, he's all in. I understand that. But when's the big reveal?
That
it was fake.
No, the big reveal is what he's dealing with now. A wedding and a wife, two kids.
Yeah.
That's it. That's the payoff.
So he's not going to reveal that it was a radio bit ever? That's weird. That's like Andy Kaufman-ish.
Well, it wasn't a radio bit is a problem.
No, we all know it was a bit. We just got to know when it's going to be fucking admitted.
He's got a family now.
All right. Well, you can do that to keep the bit going. We understand.
No, I mean like a legitimate family.